President Marcos calls out public utility drivers who have been used to disregarding traffic rules. Marcos says driving etiquette in the Philippines should be modernized alongside the government's push to upgrade traditional jeepneys. The president did not say if stiffer penalties would be imposed against traffic violators, but he says he wants Filipino drivers to be more disciplined on the road.
Tama na yung mga madamot sa daan, mga nagbababa ng pasahero sa gitna ng daan, mga hindi ginagalang ang bike lane, hindi pinapadaan ng mga ambulansya, pagpapark sa tabi ng daan na nagiging obstruction sa daloy ng traffic. Higit pa sa pagbabago at pagmoderno ng mga pampublikong sasakyan, kailangan na rin nating iwanan ang lumang pag-uugali sa kalye.
Marcos also making a case for government's controversial jeepney modernization program.
Hindi po natin pinapalitan ang ating traditional na jeepney. Ginagawang lang nating modern. Dahil yung pagkalinipat natin, ang gagawin natin electric yung mga yan, ay mas malaki ang kikitain ng ating mga nagpapasada. Dahil ang cost per kilometer ng mga electric na bagong modernized na jeepney ay mas mababa. Bukod pa ron, hindi tayo nagdadagdag sa pollution at tayo sa Pilipinas ay ginagawa natin ang lahat ng kaya natin gawin para naman tugunan ang problema ng climate change.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urges Filipinos to value the importance of history as the Philippines marked the 38th anniversary of the EDSA People Power Revolution on Sunday, which ousted his father and namesake from power. The president gave the statement in response to a letter from a sender who pointed out Filipinos have distorted the ideas of politics.
Your interest in history is very, very, very important because we have much to learn from history. And the history that has been made a long, long time ago and the history that's being made now, all of this is important. Politics should be in the service of the people. Politics should not be in the service of one party, should not be in the service of one person, certainly.
Marcos also underscored the importance of reading to avoid falling for fake news. Critics have accused Marcos and his family for hiring trolls to whitewash the atrocities committed during his father's brutal regime.
We just have to realize that politics actually is a constant. Problem is, now with the technology that we have, mahirap talagang makatingin kung ano yung fake news, ano yung totoo. It's really up to you. Huwag kayong magbabasa yung isa lang bagay. Basahin nyo lahat. Ang turo sa akin ng lola ko, sabi niya, magbasa ka ng kahit na ano. At ikaw nang bahala na mangilatis kung ano yung maganda at hindi, ano yung hindi tama. And that's what you have to do. That's what history can guide us with.
Malacanang did not release a statement in commemoration of the EDSA anniversary. Activists and relatives of martial law victims staged protests across the country to remember the EDSA People Power Revolution that toppled the Marcos regime. For attorney Shel Diokno, son of the late senator and martial law victim Jose Diokno, it is important to protect the spirit of the EDSA revolution now more than ever.
Because of the proliferation of fake news and historical revisionism, as well as the attempts to make light of what happened during that time. Democracy can be taken away overnight by the stroke of a pen, actually, and that once it's taken away, it's so very difficult to get it back.
Despite the removal of the People Power anniversary from this year's list of holidays, the National Historical Commission of the Philippines vows not to let Filipinos forget the historic event.
Yung pag-alaala naman ay hindi lang yan tuwing relaying, flag raising. Ito ay isna sa buhay araw-araw. Ano ba ang espiritu ng EDSA?
The Philippine government will start its probe on China's alleged use of cyanide in Bajo de Masinloc. Personnel from the Fisheries Bureau, the Philippine Coast Guard, and some marine scientists from UP Diliman will study the cause and extent of the coral damage in the area. The Center for Strategic and International Studies earlier claimed China's maritime activities caused massive environmental destruction in the West Philippine Sea.
There are also reaching out to the UPMSI, no, ang ating mga marine scientists also sa UP Visayas, no, to support the Philippine government. Itong paniniwala natin, no, itong mga marine scientists natin ang makakatulong sa atin na mas magkaroon ng valid assessment sa pagkasira ng marine ecosystem sa bawat ibang silog.
Sisira sir, gawa po ng mensan, may kinakalakal po yung mga Chinese yan sir.
Anong klase kalakal?
Gawa lang dati sir, yung taklobo sir. Kinukuha nila dati yung taklobo.
Talaga makikita mo sir, patay na talaga. Illegal fishing sir. Yan silang ano eh, EBC na pambomba. Yung ginagamit nila panghuli ng live lapu-lapu.
Now let's get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Alzar Aurelio. Good morning, Alzar.
Hello, good morning to all of you. Today, we expect a cool weather over Luzon due to a northeast monsoon. The said monsoon also will bring cloudy sky with light rains over Cagayan Valley, Aurora, and Quezon. While the rest of Luzon will have generally fair weather but expect isolated light rains. There is also effect of easterlies, so generally warm weather over the rest of the country, aside from isolated rain showers or thunderstorms. Forecast temperature over Metro Manila is from 24 up to 32 degrees Celsius. That's our weather update from PAGASA. I am Alzar D. Aurelio.
Thank you very much for that update, Alzar.